I think there are many people who absolutely see that it is critical to improve the food systems for going to space. But how do you do it? The way of technology development has been, let's just do the simplest thing as possible. And I believe in a vision where we need more than that. We need to say, how do we take care of people? So not only do people survive in space, but they're actually thriving.
3, 2, 1, 0, and lift off.
I'm Larissa Zhou. I'm a fourth year graduate student in mechanical engineering at Harvard. I would say that my work broadly is about feeding in extreme environments. What started it is that I was working as a food scientist and living in Seattle, and I got really into the outdoors and backpacking. And I was eating these freeze-dried meals and thinking, oh, you know, what is the science behind this? I started realizing a lot of these technologies hadn't changed in a long time. Freeze-drying hadn't changed. And what would it mean to develop technologies to preserve food or to develop products that allow people to go further when they're exploring or to have a more enjoyable dining experience in harsh, hard conditions? Right now, we have astronauts on the International Space Station who are able to rehydrate food. And a lot of what they're eating are very similar to the sort of freeze-dried foods that backpackers encounter. And on the International Space Station, they can only rehydrate it or reheat it. There is no capability to actually turn a raw material, raw food material, into a hot, cooked, delicious meal. So the solution that I came up in the form of hardware to solve that problem of how do you actually cook something in water in microgravity was to use specialized geometry. So in my case, the pot actually looks like a triangular wedge. And to use capillary forces instead of gravity to keep water where I want it to be. Nobody had ever tried to cook, nobody had ever tried to heat something, and especially try to have irregularly shaped objects like food, like pasta, in the container. I wanted to design and to build a prototype, which in theory ought to work, but then I need to test it. So I tested it in a microgravity flight. The key on the first flight was just to see, okay, does this particular geometry, does this particular shape really keep the water where I want it to be? I made both sides of the pot transparent out of Pyrex glass so I can see through it. I can see through it, and also I put a backlight on one end that lights up the inside, and I put a GoPro on the other end. In that particular case, I was cooking pasta. I had a little tube of pasta in the pot as well, and it was capturing what's going on with all of those things inside the pot. So then the second year, what I wanted to do is to actually try to eat the pasta. And that was something me, as the designer of the technology, I really wanted to experience. So for example, I removed the thing while we were just on the straight and narrow portion, and I fished out the pasta, and then I put the back lid on, and then in microgravity, I tried to eat it. It took several tries for me, where ultimately I just had to like try to smash it into my mouth in order to land it. Some of the difficulties in my research has been saying, I want to work on this thing that I don't see anybody else doing. How do I work on it? Can I work on it? I think it's easy to feel like you're alone on that path. So we have InTouch, where we go and as peer advisors and approach students and talk to students, and they can come to us. And I hope that by, again, putting this out there, that others are also motivated and excited to think about this really cool problem and to say, okay, you know, there's somebody, me, you know, who's worked on how to boil pasta in space, but maybe somebody else will work on how to cook bread in space or how to mill flour, let's say, etc. And there's been little pockets of development all around the world on this, but we really need a lot more, because more and more people are going to space. There are more and more plans to send people deeper into space. And how do we go there sustainably? How do we go there equitably? Food is just a part of that. It's also a really important part of that, because without food, we cannot go.